ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते राधानाथ स्वामिनिति नामिने नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणि प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादि पश्चत्य देशतारिणे ओम ज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितमेन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितमेन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं वंदेगम श्री गुरु श्रीयुत पद कमलं श्री गुरुं वैष्णवांश्च श्री रूपं सागर जातं सकगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सकगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांस हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधु जगतपदे गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विषमानु सूते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे ईश्वर परम कृष्ण सच्चिदानंद विग्रह अनादिरादिर गोविंदा सर्व कारण कारणम हरे कृष्ण। पैलॉट श्री कृष्णास कॉसलेस मर्सी। वी आर नाइसली प्रोग्रेसिंग इन द 8th चैप्टर ऑफ भगवद गीता अटेनिंग द सुप्रीम। सो इन दिस चैप्टर अर्जुन आस्क्ड सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस इन द श्लोकास 1 एंड 2 इन द फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड श्लोकास एंड कृष्ण आंसर एवरीथिंग in the third and fourth sloka except one question. So that one question is going to be the answer. All the remaining slokas in the 8 chapters, Krishna is going to answer that one question. Not only that, the 9th chapter also, the most confidential knowledge, there also Krishna is continuing the answer for them. Because Arjuna's question, that one question was, that prayana kale cha katam nyayosi niyatatmabhi. So at the time of death, how to know you? That means how to remember you. So this is a science. So from Bhagavad Gita, we understand we are the soul and the soul has to connect with the super soul. That is Paramatma. Then what we are doing is the right thing. So that means the desire. The desire in ourselves, the desiring to connect with the super soul. That's what is matters. Because as a soul, we have the free will. So that free will, we need to exercise our free will. We need to use our free will. And we should use our free will in the right way. So, like we say that we have freedom. So we have freedom to do everything, correct? So that freedom, really, in fact, really speaking, we don't have freedom. No one is free in this world. Everyone is forced. Everyone is controlled. Nahi kashchit chanam api jatu tisthati akarmakrit. So if we have freedom, then we should be able to decide whether we want to do something or not. But that's not the case. We are not free to choose what we are going to do. That's not the case. Only we are free to choose what we want. Only we are free to desire. That's it. But how we are going to do, what we are going to do, all those things are not in our hands. So that freedom we don't have. So that's what we need to understand from Bhagavad Gita, that Krishna is saying that not even a single moment one can refrain from doing something. So since because we have got freedom, we cannot say that I want to do my own way. It's not possible here. Because we are restricted by so many ways. There are so many constraints in this material world. And we are all the time forced to act helplessly by the three modes of material nature. That's why nahi kasyati kshanam api jatu tisthati akarma krit. Akarma krit means not doing any action. Not doing any activity. That's what akarma krit. Nahi kasyati kshanam api. Kshanam means a moment. not even a single moment one can refrain from doing something, because everyone is forced to act helplessly by the three modes of material nature. Karyategi avasaka karma sarvaka prakriti jay gunahi. So that way we have free will. We have the free will means we have the freedom to desire what we want, but we don't have the freedom to act. So if we desire to gratify this material senses, if we desire to enjoy this material sense objects, so then what's going to happen? We will be forced to act according to the type of the what mode of nature is forcing us, the mode of goodness, mode of passion, and mode of ignorance. But if you use that same free will, if you use that same free will to remember Krishna, to connect Krishna, so then that is going to help us to free ourselves from these modes of material nature. And that way, by remembering Krishna, by knowing about Krishna, we will be able to get rid of this material world itself. So that's what Arjuna is asking the question, that prayana kale cha katam yeyosi niyattatmavi, at the time of death, how to know you? That's what Arjuna is asking the question. So while studying Bhagavad Gita, we understand very well in the first six chapters that we are the soul and we need to control our mind. And we understand very well about the relationship between mind, senses, intelligence, and the interactions between them. We understand very, very well. So, indriyani parani ahu indriyevya parammanaka manasastu parabuddhi yobuddhe paratastu saha. So, the senses are superior to dull matter. Mind is above the senses. Intelligence is above the mind. Soul is above the intelligence. So, now we need to know how to gain intelligence. And we need to know how to control our mind. So that way we will also know how to control our senses. So that's why we need to understand the relationship between senses, mind, intelligence, soul, body. This is science. And this science is applicable to each and every one. So this science means science doesn't belong to any religions. So science means it's a perfect science. So Krishna is saying that the senses, first body, then senses, then mind, then intelligence, then soul. So they are all connected. So now, here, the soul is going to suffer if mind is controlled by the senses. And the soul is going to enjoy if mind is controlled by the soul through intelligence. So if we have intelligence, then if we are able to control our mind, then we are going to enjoy. So, but if we don't control our mind, then the mind will be controlled by the senses. So then we are going to suffer. We are going to struggle. So that way, with our free will, if we misuse our free will, if we misuse our free will, our mind will go out of control. So then we will suffer in this material world. But if we properly use our free will, then we will be able to control our mind. So when our mind is under our control, then it will do what we say. What the mind is friend. If it is controlled, it is our friend. So then it's going to help us. So that way, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is teaching us very clearly how to make our mind as our best friend. There is a science. So that way, we should be able to control our senses with the help of the mind. So that's why Krishna is saying in the third chapter, Karmendriyani samyamya, ya aste manasasmaran indriyarthan. So we need to understand all these words here. Karmendriya means the working senses. So Karmendriyani samyamya means while trying to control the working senses. What are the working senses? Our legs, hands, and voice, and anus and genital, they are all working senses, karmendriyas. So while trying to control the working senses, karmendriyani samyamya, we We can try to keep our hands like this, legs like this, not going to do anything. I don't want to do this like that. We can try controlling it. But Krishna is saying that, ya aste manasasmaran indriyarthan. But if the mind remembers, if the mind thinks about the sense objects, ya aste manasasmaran indriyarthan, then Krishna is saying that we are fools. Vimudatma. We are fools. So, karmendriyani samyamya ya aste manasasmaran indriyarthan vimudatma midyacharagasa uchyate, then he is just a pretender. So we are only acting. We really cannot control our senses. So we cannot control our mind. So that's why Krishna is saying in the next sloka in the third chapter, that's why yastvindriyani manasa niyamya arabate Arjuna. So that's why with the help of mind, yastvindriyani, the senses, niyamya means regulate. So one should regulate the senses with the help of mind. Yastvindriyani manasa niyamya arabate Arjuna. So karmendriyaihi karma yogam. So with karmendriyas, with our working senses, we should perform karma yoga. Karmendriyaihi karma yogam. What is karma yogam? Asaktaha. Asaktaha means not attached. That means not affected by the results. So asaktaha tesu karmasu. So that means we should not be attached to the duties. We should not attach to our actions. We should not have any attachment to the results. So that's why Krishna is saying that yastvindriyani manasa niyamya arabate Arjuna karmendriyaihi karma yogam asaktaha tesu karmasu. Asaktaha tesu visishyati. So that is better. It's better to control our senses with the help of mind instead of just trying to control our senses, but the mind is remembering the sense objects, then it is a problem. So that's what we understand very clearly in Bhagavad Gita. Krishna is saying that all these things are possible only if we are able to control our mind first. If we are able to control our mind first, then we will be able to control our senses. Yastvindriyani manasa. Because we need to control our senses by the mind. So if we don't control our mind, then we cannot control our senses. So that means we will lose our intelligence. That means we will not have intelligence. So that's what we need to understand from Bhagavad Gita. The real intelligence, the real intelligent way of acting is not getting affected by the results. So that means not attached to the results. That is the main thing. So that doesn't mean in no way in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is saying that give up your work. Don't do any work. That's not Krishna is saying that. Krishna is saying that you have a right to do your work. Karmanyeva adhigaraste. You have a right to perform your duty. But you don't have the right to claim the results. That is the main thing. Karmanyeva adhigaraste ma palesu kadasana. But you don't have the right over the results. That point we should be very clearly, we should understand. So that way we can do, we can work. We can do whatever we want here because we have the right to perform our duty. Whatever means, it's not that whatever we want we can do, only the prescribed duties. That's why Krishna is saying that niyatam kuru karmatvam, niyatam kuru karmatvam karma jayohi akarmana. Because there are karma, akarma, vikarma are there. So akarma, karma is the duty we are doing. Akarma means not doing, inaction. Action is karma, inaction is akarma. But forbidden action is vikarma. That's why Krishna is saying that karma no happy bodhavyam cha vikarmanaha. Akarmanascha bodhavyam gahana karmano gatihi. One should know what action is, what is action, and what is inaction, and what are forbidden actions. That's what we need to know. So that's why we should do regulated duties. That's what niyamya. Niyatam kuru karma. In fact, in one sloka, Krishna is saying that durenagi avaram karma buddhi yoga dhananjaya. By using your intelligence, keep all abominable activities at a far distant, far distance. Dureneki avaram karma, buddhi yoga dhananjaya, buddhau saranam anvicha, kripana palahetava. So persons who are going after the results are misers, kripana palahetava. So that way, in this world, the reality, the fact, the scientific fact, the truth is that materially speaking, we can get whatever we want as long as it is prescribed duties. And everything is going to come to us. We are going to always become very successful in our efforts. Only when we are not disturbed by the results. Only when we are not attached to the results. So that's why it's very, very important. Understanding this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita is very, very important. So that way it teaches us. The Bhagavad Gita teaches us very scientifically. It gives us the clear procedure, step-by-step instructions about how to control our mind and how to make our mind as our best friend. So our mind should be our best friend. So we should not keep our mind as our worst enemy all the time. If we keep our mind as our worst enemy, then always it's going to bring us trouble. Always we are going to struggle and suffer in this material world. So that is going to be possible only by connecting with Krishna, only by studying this Bhagavad Gita knowledge and just following all the instructions given by Krishna to control our mind. There is simply no other way to control the mind, no other way. We cannot do by any amount of any type of medications. They are not going to help us. We cannot go to a psychiatrist and tell that I want to control my mind. It is not possible. So the mind control, the art of mind control is very, very clearly explained in Bhagavad Gita. So we simply need to have the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita and apply that knowledge in our life. That's it. Then we can control the mind. So that way, remembrance, the mind, what our mind remembers, that's what is very, very important. So that way we need to focus based on Bhagavad Gita in order to control the mind. We should forget about all these material sense objects. That is the main thing. It's all going to come. Whatever we need, God is already supplying everything. We just take it for granted. Everything belongs to me. Everything, I am doing it. I am the doer like that. But God has already sahayajnaha prajasristva purovacha prajapati anena prasavasyadvam esavoshtu ishtakamaduk. Krishna has produced all the necessities, whatever we need to live in this world, everything has already been produced. And along with us, the yajnas, the performance of offerings, their procedures, that also is available. So we need to understand this science very well, that everything is supplied by God, everything is very well taken care of by God, and we simply cannot, due to ahankara, due to false ego, we cannot simply think that I'm the doer, I'm the enjoyer. So then only we are putting ourselves into trouble and we are putting everyone also in trouble in this material. Just by thinking that I'm the doer, I'm the enjoyer, I can enjoy. It's not going to be possible. Everybody who wanted to rule this world, everyone died miserably. No one can live here forever. That part we need to understand very, very clearly. But if you have the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we can decide about our next life. We can actually prepare for our next body very well. So that's why Arjuna is asking such a great question, is that prayana kale cha katam nyeyo si niyata atma vidhi. So at the time of death, how to remember you? Because Krishna said that sadhi bhutadi devam maam sadhi yajnam cha ye vidugu prayana kale picha maam te vidugu yukta chetas. So that's why Krishna consciousness is very, very important. Remembering Krishna is very, very important with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, of course. Of course, when we get the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we are going to get the complete knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. We are not going to take some slokas and accept, and some slokas we reject. It's not going to be possible. Then we are not going to get the knowledge. So if you are studying this Bhagavad Gita as a science, it is a science. There is no doubt about it. And we should get the complete knowledge of this Bhagavad Gita. Full knowledge. When we have the complete knowledge of this Bhagavad Gita, we will be able to act as per the instructions given in this Bhagavad Gita. So this is the Shastra. So That way, we need to study Bhagavad Gita very well. That's why we are studying Bhagavad Gita every day. And we are making great progress. We are making good progress. We are understanding. So, here, in this sloka, what we are going to study today, it's a very important sloka, the sloka number 5, in the 8th chapter. Because Arjuna asked, we already know what are the questions in the first and second sloka in the 8th chapter, what Arjuna asked. Kim tat brahma, kim adhyatma, kim karma, purushottama, adidevam, adibhutam kim proktam, adidevam kim uchadi. Adiyajnaka katam kotra, degesmin madhusudana, prayana kalecha katam yeyosi niyatatma. And Krishna already explained about what is Brahma, what is karma, everything we already studied. Aksharam Brahma Paramam Swabhavo Dhyatma Muchyate Bhuta Bhavo Bhavakaro Visargaga Karma Samjitaga Adibhutam Charo Bhavaga Purushascha Adidevatam Ati Yajno Gamye Vatra Dehe Dega Vritambara. So Krishna said that I am the Adi Yajna. So Krishna is the enjoyer of all performance, all the offerings, all the sacrifices. Krishna is the Adi Yajna. So whereas we are the Aksharam Brahma, we are the Brahman, the soul is the Brahman, Aksharam Brahma Paramam. Swabhava, our eternal nature is called Adhyatma. Swabhavo Adhyatma Uchyate. When our body is produced, so at that time the karma is taking place, the action is taking place. That's what is the karma. The karma is starting even at the time of the production of our body. So that's why bhuta bhavod bhavakaro visargaga karma samjitam. Adibhutam charo bhavagam. So adibhutam is the fallible one, that is the material world, the material nature. Earth, water, fire, air, space, all these things are all adibhutam. Adibhutam charo bhavagam. Purushascha adi devatam. So the adi devam is the demigods. Adi devam. Purushascha adi devatam. Adi agnyoham. So Krishna is the adi agnyo. So Krishna is the adi agnyo. Now the question what Arjuna asked, prayana kale cha katam yeyosi niyatatma bhi. At the time of death, how can one remember you? How can one know you? So in the next sloka, in the sloka number 8.5, Krishna is teaching us that. Antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram yaprayati samadbhavam yati nasti atra samsayaga. That's what Krishna is teaching. Antakale cha means at the time of death. Antakalam. Anta means end, finish. So when our death comes to, when our life ends, when the death comes, so antakala, antakale cha mameva smaran. Anyone who remembers me, that's what mameva smaran, muktva kalevaram, means giving up this body, muktva kalevaram. So mameva smaran muktva kalevaram. Kalevaram means the body, muktva means quitting. So at the time of death, at the time of quitting this body, at the time of leaving this body, antakale cha mameva smaran muktva, mameva smaran. Anyone who remembers me at the time of death, antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram, ya prayatisa madbhavam, he will attain my nature. That means we will go to Krishna's well. Ya prayatisa madbhavam. Na yati, madbhavam yati. So he will reach, he will attain my nature. Ya prayati sa madbhavam yati, na asti atra samsega. Na asti means there is no samsaya, doubt. So there is no doubt about this. Na asti atra samsaya. Atra means in this, there is no doubt. So, antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram ya prayati sa madbhavam yati na asti atra samse. So, at the time of death, anyone remembers me, he will attend me without fail. There is no doubt about it. No doubt about this. That's what Krishna is doing. So, what does that mean? That means we should remember Krishna at the time of death if we want to free ourselves from this material veil. That is the only way we can go to Krishna. Only by remembering Krishna at the time of death. That's why in Bhagavad Gita, repeatedly Krishna in many, many slokas that you remember me, always think of me, become my devotee. Krishna is repeatedly, mayyarpita mano buddhi mame vesisi asam sayaka. So if you offer your mind and intelligence unto me, you will come to me, there is no doubt about it. Mayyeva mana adatsva mayi buddhim nivesega. Fix your mind upon me, focus your intelligence upon me. So that way Krishna is keep on saying that. Ananya chetaga satatam yomam smarati nityasaga tasyagam sulabhaka partha nityuktasya yogina. Anyone who remembers me all the time without any gap, without any deviation, ananya. Ananya chetaga satatam yomam smarati nityasaga tasyagam sulabhaka partha. For him, I am very easy to obtain. That's why tasyagam sulabhaka partha. So that way, the only way to reach Krishna is by remembering him. That's why Krishna is there saying that, and the only way to control our mind is to remember Krishna. So both are these things. Because our mind only has to remember Krishna at the time of death. Because mind is the only tool with which we can connect with Krishna now, and with which we can liberate from this material veil and remember Krishna at the time of death. So the only tool what we have with us is our mind. So that's why Krishna is saying that manasamyamya machitto. By always thinking about me, you control your mind. That's why manasamyamya machitto yukta asita matparaga. Keeping me as your destination. Keeping me as your destination, you always manasamyamya machitto yukta asita matparaga. So always think about me and control your mind. Manasamya, manasamyamya means control your mind by always thinking about me. So now, if you do like that now, right now, when we are living, when we everything is going good, when everything is going great, we are able to chant, we are able to focus our mind on Krishna. So now is the time we cannot waste. This time is very important. We should focus, we should remember Krishna by chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. That is the only universal Maha Mantra. When we chant this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we should focus our mind on the transcendental sound vibration. All other senses are shut. So we are focusing. Of course, we need to chant in such a way that we can hear it. So when we are hearing it, we should focus our ears, our hearing process on that sound vibration. That's why it's called the transcendental sound vibration. And Krishna is saying that sit straight, don't look at any other directions, and just control your mind. So that way, we should simply close and don't look at any other directions and simply look down towards your nose. So, nasikagram, samprekse nasikagram swam, this is chanavalokayan. So, then we have to chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. At that time, focus our mind on the transcendental sound vibration. So mind will go here and there. Bring that mind and again fix, again focus on that sound vibration. Yato yato nischalati manaschanchalam astiram tatastato niyamyaitat atmanyeva vasam nayet. From wherever the mind wanders, due to its flickering and unsteady nature, one must certainly withdraw it and bring it back under the control of the self. So when we do this chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, this mind, exercise for the mind. So mind is going to go here and there and bring it back and focus it on that transcendental sound vibration. So that way, if we are able to do it on a daily basis, so there is 16 rounds. Each round is 108 times telling this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So that way, if we are able to do this practice very nicely, very sincerely, as Krishna explained, as Krishna given very nicely, he has given all the instructions in the sixth chapter, then our mind is not going to go anywhere. Then over a period of time, if you do this process, then when we chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. So our mind will just focus, stay in the sound vibration. So that is the technical process to control our mind. So once we are able to do that, that means we are able to control our mind. That means we are able to remember Krishna. And then all the time, whenever, whatever we are doing, if you are going to study, study for Krishna, if you are going to work, work for Krishna, if you are going to eat, eat for Krishna, anything, whatever we do it for Krishna. Yat karosi, yat dasnasi, yat jugosi, tadasiyate, yat tapasasi kaunteya tat kuruswa madarpanam. Whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you offer or give away, and whatever austerities you perform, do that, O son of Kunti, as an offering unto me. So that way, if our life 24/7 is full of Krishna, Krishna consciousness, then what is going to happen at the time of death? You know, at the time of death, anytime that can come, we will be very well prepared for that event. So whenever that death comes, at that time we will be remembering Krishna only. We will be focusing our mind only on Krishna. Then we can remember Krishna at the time of death. So antakalecha mameva smaran muktva kalivaram yaprayati samadbhavam yati nasti atra samsaya. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we have successfully finished sloka number 5 in the 8th chapter today. And I will stop now. I will discuss if any questions are there. Hare Krishna.
Vishnu Babu has a question in the chat window.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you can have, if you have any questions, you can also type in the chat window. That will help me to answer you first. And before I go with Vishnu Baba, I just want to find out the new devotees.